Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is me, your host Brajwal, and this is a beginner-friendly step-by-step guide for Metamask. So let's get started. As always, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up and show your support. Subscribe and hit the bell icon if you'd like to be notified for future uploads. And if you have any questions or any queries, please leave them in the comments below. So let's jump in the tutorial. So what is MetaMask? So MetaMask is a Ethereum-based wallet or a gateway that is available as a plugin or an extension on your PC or laptop browser, regardless of what operating system you use. Using MetaMask, you can create a wallet that allows you to connect and use different DAPPS, which stands for decentralized applications, purchase, swap, or store tokens in the ETH ecosystem, or Ethereum compatible systems, where Ethereum stands for Ethereum Virtual Machine. For example, your Fantom, Mover, Binance Smart Chain, and much more. Second, what is MetaMask used for? Like I said earlier, MetaMask is used to connect to DApps, decentralized applications, and user services, which can be such as swapping tokens, purchasing tokens, yield farming, do all of the DeFi stuff. And since it's a Web3 wallet, you can use it to hold your tokens, NFTs, on the ETH blockchain or the Ethereum compatible chains. Just a note, the tokens or the NFT are not stored inside the wallet, but when you create a wallet, you are assigned a wallet that is unique to yourself, which can be accessed only by using the MetaMask wallet that you have created. You can also import your wallet and use it on other applications that support or are similar to MetaMask. So where can you install MetaMask? So you can install your MetaMask on your PC regardless of operating system, as long as you have a supported browser, for example, Microsoft Edge, that is built on the latest Chromium framework, or Mozilla Firefox, or Google Chrome, or even your Brave browser is fine. And you can also install it on your phone as a application, for example, MetaMask application on your iPhone or on Android, and also basically the same thing as on your PC. I'm going to show you how you can install it on your PC and on your phone. But the part where I show you the configurations and settings, I'll show you on the computer, but it's also exactly the same as you would do on a PC, as you would on a phone as well. Let's jump on the browser and see how that's done. Today, for the purpose of this guide, I'm going to use Firefox, but you can also use any other browser that supports this wallet or the extension. So if you go to metamask.io, always make sure that you are visiting the genuine website. It's metamask.io, and there's a download button. You can have a look if you'd like to learn more about it. And to download it, click on download now. As I said, it supports Chrome, Firefox, Brave, Edge, right? So I'm going to click install MetaMask for Firefox. It's taking me to the plugin, add to Firefox. So the installation process is exactly the same on all the browsers. Click on add. So for Chrome, it will take you to the Chrome store, and for Brave, it will also take you to the Chrome store. And similar for Edge as well. So now the plugin has been installed and it says welcome to MetaMask. You can get started. Since we are creating a wallet, I'm going to click on create a wallet. This is showing you, giving me the information on what data does MetaMask collect. Click on I agree, create a password. Once you've entered the password, click on I have read, click on create. You can save that if you like. I'm not going to save that for now. And this is showing you how to secure your wallet. You can go through that and read through it, but I have a guide coming up in the future where I show you how you can connect it to a hardware wallet. So if you would like to be notified about that, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon. Now click on next. And this is the most important part of the guide or the tutorial. So when you click on reveal secret words, you get these 12 words. So these 12 words are the gatekeepers or the key to your wallet, right? So anyone that has these words will have full access to the wallet, regardless of whatever the password you put in or stuff like that. So make sure you do not share this with anyone, or make sure if anyone asks for a seed phrase, you never give out the seed phrase, as no one should require a seed phrase unless they're trying to scam you or hack your wallet. So make sure you keep it somewhere safe. I always suggest you to write it down. So if you are going to use it to hold a huge amount of funds, never write it, never type it on your computer, or never store it on a computer, because you never know what kind of vulnerabilities your computer might have. So make sure you write it down if that's possible. Once you've written that down, click on next. Now you got to enter the words as in the same order that they were in the previous step. Once that's done, click on confirm. And it says congratulations, click on all done. So now your wallet is ready. That's how you create a wallet or set up a wallet on your PC. Now let's see how that's done on a phone. So for the purpose of this video, I'm going to use iPhone, but it's exactly the same process for your Android phone as well. So go on search for MetaMask. Make sure you download the one from Consensus. If you scroll down, you should see Consensus AG. So make sure that's the one. Download it. Shouldn't take very long. So once it's downloaded, tap on open. Welcome to MetaMask. Click on get started. Click on create a new wallet. Click on I agree. Enter the password, any password that you prefer. Once that's done, since this iPhone supports Face ID, you can enable or disable Face ID. I'm going to enable that for now. Create password. And the wallet's created. It's showing you the same steps as on the PC. Secure wallet. Click on start. Click on start again. And this is a really important step. Like I explained earlier, make sure that you do not share this with anyone or store it or write it down where someone else has access to it. Because if anyone has access to your seed phrase, they'll have full access to your wallet as well. And also, no one should request or ask you for your seed phrase ever. So tap on view and enter the words in the same order that they were presented to you in the earlier step. Once that's done, you should see success and click on complete backup. And congratulations, your wallet has been created. Click on done. And your wallet is ready for use. Now, I just want to go through some of the basic settings or things you should know about a MetaMask wallet. I'm going to create a advanced settings or the advanced guide for MetaMask as well. So once that's up, I'll make sure that it's on the top right corner or in the description. If not, please make sure you go through the channel once it's uploaded. For the purpose of this video, I'm just going to keep it very basic and simple. So if you look in the top, this is your wallet address. This can be accessed if you open the wallet. It can be accessed from the top as well. So if you click on it, it'll copy your address. So any Ethereum based tokens or ETH should be sent to this wallet. So for example, you have Ethereum on your Binance. You will send Ethereum to this wallet via the Ethereum network or ERC20 network when you send ETH. And for example, if you have any tokens that are based or that are ERC20 based, they will send them here and you got to make sure that you are sending it through ERC20. And they will reach your wallet, but you won't see them straight away. So what you need to do is, for example, if I purchase a little bit of Truebit on other exchange, for example, Bitmart and any other wallet, and if I want to send that to this wallet, what I need to do is I'll need to copy this, go there, send Truebit to this wallet. And once the Truebit is sent, what I need to do is you need to come here and import tokens. So you can either search for them. So if I search for Truebit protocol, nothing comes up, right? So what you need to do is you need the contract address for that protocol or for that token. So if we go to CoinGecko, this lists all the tokens. So for example, if you are buying or if you are purchasing a very new token or for a very new project, you need to have the contract address. And sometimes a token might not be listed on CoinGecko as well. In that case, you have to make sure that you copy it from DexTools or any other places that you found the token from. For example, for the purpose of this video, I'm going to search for Truebit protocol. And also another thing is when you look into the contract, you see the logo here. This usually shows which ecosystem or what this token is based on. So it's showing me ETH because Truebit protocol is based on ERC20 or Ethereum based token. I'll click on that to copy, or you can directly click on this logo to add it to MetaMask. Click on add token, or for example, if you have a contract address you found on Twitter or any other places that you just purchased, you click on the address, you go back to MetaMask here, or you can go to MetaMask here, the same thing. If you want to get to this page where it's a sort of a tab, what you need to do is you click on the plugin, click on the three dots and click on expand view. This opens your wallet in a new tab and it's easier to manage instead of clicking on the plugin icon, which disappears every now and then. Once that's done, click on import tokens. Click on custom token if it's not available under search and paste your contract address. And it should detect the symbol, which is the token name and the decimal. Click on add custom token and import tokens. And it's as a moment, it says zero true. So that's fine because it doesn't have any token at all. So don't worry about the symbol at the front. As long as the contract address is correct, it should be fine. And if you don't see the dollar amount under your tokens, that means the token is not being tracked properly by CoinGecko, CoinMarketCap and stuff like that, because MetaMask pulls its data from CoinGecko, CoinMarketCap and websites like that. So if those websites don't have it correctly, or if the data is not updated correctly, you won't see anything here, or whatever you see is it won't be correct. So don't worry about that. And if it's a fairly new token, it takes time for MetaMask to update that, or CoinGecko and CoinMarketCap to update that. So that's fine. So that was adding a token. Next thing is, if since you're going to use this, probably you're going to use this to transact or connect to dApps and stuff, it's very helpful to know about the gas. If you go to your account, click on settings. If you go to advanced, there's an option called advanced gas control. So if you enable this, what happens is when you are trying to make a transaction, you can sort of control and you can sort of have a better control on how to or how much gas to spend or how the transaction should go through. I'll go through these steps in much deeper in another video. So for the purpose of this video, it's helpful to enable the gas controls, right? Another thing is, if you go to general, if you go to currency conversion, so you can set it to USD or you can set it to the currency of your choice. Another thing is, if you forgot your recovery phrase or the 12 word phrase that you had earlier, what you can do is, as long as you have that logged in or if you have that wallet set up in any computer or any phone or anything like that, you can go into settings, right? You can go into settings, you can go into security and privacy. And as you can see, it says reveal secret recovery phrase. Click on that, but does require you the password that you use to log into the plugin. If I enter the password, this will give me the recovery phrase, right? So and then I can create a backup or whatever you want to do with it. You can also add a contact. For example, you have a Binance address for ETH, or you have another wallet that you would like to save as contact. You can click on add contact, right? Or if you are sending, for example, ETH to Binance, you can save it as ETH Binance, right? And then paste the address here, paste the address and click on save. So next time, if you want to send something to Binance, for example, I want to send some ETH to Binance, I can just go to the plugin. I can go send, and it will be listed here. Sometimes it has happened to me where I've copied a wrong thing and pasted and sent tokens to a wrong address. And if you send token to a wrong address, or if you send a token to a wrong chain, there's no way you can revert that. And if you send it to the wrong person, that's it, right? So it's always good to save your important contacts or the contacts or the wallet that you interact with frequently as a contract address, like here. And then when you want to send something, you can just go there, send it, and then enter everything else, and then you can send it. Another thing is, for example, you have connected your wallet to different websites, right? For example, if you've been using it for a few months, you might have interacted with different protocols, different services. What you can do is you disconnect those sites. So if you go to the wallet, so if you go to the plugin, if you click on the three dots and there's connected sites, you can it's not connected to any sites at the moment, but you can disconnect them. For example, if I go to Uniswap, I connect my wallet, MetaMask, next, connect, right? And then I go to Zapper.fi and I connect my wallet, MetaMask, next, connect. So I've connected my MetaMask to Zapper.fi and Uniswap. So if I click on the plugin and click on this and connect the sites, as you can see, I have these connections underneath. So what you can do is, you can delete them. That will disconnect your wallet from that. So next time you'll have to reconnect again. I'm not exactly sure how safe that makes it. I'm not sure if that completely removes the history of the wallet interaction with the protocol or services, but it's something that I do every now and then, just in case I have my wallet connected to too many websites or protocols. If there is anything else that was basic that I forgot in this video, please make sure you leave it in the comments. And I am preparing for a much more advanced tutorial for MetaMask. So if you have anything that you'd like me to include in that, please make sure you leave them in the comments as well. And as always, if this was helpful, please leave a like. If there's any feedback and suggestions, and also leave that in the comments as well. And subscribe and hit the bell icon for future uploads. And you have a nice day. Thank you.